right, guys, welcome back. We got a white pine loaded on here just a moment ago with my tractor. Not the most delicate landing, but we got it up here nonetheless. You guys can imagine I try to set it up here as gently as possible. It's not because I don't think the mill can take it, but if you can imagine a piece of weight like this, if you drop it from any height, well, anything's going to break. So I try to just ease it on there. This is probably going to end up being some 4x4s here today. This is a section of white pine from that white pine you saw me cut recently. This is one of the branches of that white pine. It's not the main part. The main part I cut last time. This I thought was a bit straighter. It's not all that straight, but we'll make the best of it. I'll probably have to lose a little bit of the top and a little bit of the bottom to make a square cant, but that's how it goes with sawing. As I said, I need some 4x4s for an upcoming project. And so one of the great things about owning a sawmill is the next time you have a log on your mill, you just sort of pick it out of it. And that's what we're doing here today. Glad you guys are here. Here we go. I'm gonna call it quits there. I've got some more logs just up the hill there that I'm gonna bring back to the sawmill before long. I think the rain is just about upon us. I can tell you the bugs are certainly on us. I don't know about where you guys live, but the bugs bite me on the inside of my ears, the back of my ears. And so when I'm sawing sometime, I don't know how they do it, but they're sneaking their way in behind my earmuffs and biting me right along the perimeter of the actual ear protection there. But that's the worst of my problems. I guess I'm doing pretty good. Guys, you all take care out there. Make sure you subscribe. Give me the old like-a-roo, and I'll see you next time.